मॉर्निंग क्लास टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आवर नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इन अ सेकेंड चैप्टर इज द फंक्शन. वी ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड आवर एरे पॉइंट इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी स्टार्टेड आवर न्यू पॉइंट दैट इज फंक्शन. आवर सेकेंड चैप्टर दैट इज एरे फंक्शन एंड स्ट्रिंग already started and in that we completed our array point in a previous lecture and we started our next point that is function in this lecture. In previous lecture we discussed or we studied the concept of splice and the object as a associative array. Splice means what? Splice is a method or it is an inbuilt method in a JavaScript which is used to modify the content of an array by removing the existing element and or by adding a new element. And the syntax of a splice method is array.splice in a parenthesis index comma remove count or you can write how many keyword comma item list means element of list element 1 up to element n. In that index is a required parameter and this parameter is the index we start modifying the array with the origin at the 0th index and the index and the next parameter is a how many parameter which is optional parameter and it is a integer value indicating that the number of old array elements to remove if the how many is set to 0, no elements are removed. And element 1 to element n are the elements to add and add to the array and it is optional. Or new elements to be added to the array is the element parameters. This is a splice method. Next is a object as a associative and array means what? Without passing the index of an array we pass the strings as a index in an array is called as a associative array. In previous lecture we discussed a splice and object associative array with their different examples. Now in this lecture we started our new concept that is function. Let us see outline of today's lecture. First is what is meant by function. Second point is defining a function. Third is writing a function. Fourth point is adding an array argument. Adding an arguments. And last is the scope of variable and arguments. First point is definition of function. What is meant by function? You already learned this concept in C language. That is function, array and string. Function means what? Function is a subprogram or set of instruction written to do a specific task. It's called as a function. Or you can also say that function is a group of statement or block of statement together to perform a specific task. It's called as a function. Or you can also say that function is a self-contained block of statement that can be executed repeatedly whenever we need it. This is called as a function. First question is define a function and write a syntax to create a function in a JavaScript. And answer for this question is a function is a subprogram designed to perform a particular task. A function is mainly a subprogram designed to perform a particular task. Next is a function are executed when they are called. It is executed when they are called and this is known as a invoking a function. Next is a values can be passed into functions and used within the function. Whatever the value can be passed into function that can be used within a function. And next point, function always returns a value. In JavaScript, if no return value is specified, the function will return a undefined value. Means it return a undefined value. So functions are objects in JavaScript. Types of function, there are mainly two types of function. First is a user defined function, built in function, and second is a user defined function. What is mean by built in function? Built in function is the function that are already defined in a JavaScript. For example, write function, alert function, prompt function, these are the some examples of built in function. Or we also say that built-in function means system provided this function is called as a built-in function. Next is a user-defined function. User-defined function means what? User-defined function which are written by the user or defined by the user at the time of writing a program is called as a user-defined function. And this function are the simple functions, means it is defined by the user is called as a user defined function. Next point is a defining a function. A function must be defined before it can be called in a JavaScript. Means that before we use a function, we need to define that function. And the function definition is sometimes also termed as a function declaration or a function statement. The common way to define a function in a JavaScript is by using a function keyword followed by the function name. The process of creating a function is called as defining a function. And the process of using a function is referred as a calling a function. Process of using function is called a calling a function, and process of creating a function is called as a defining a function. And before we use a function, we need to define that function. A function definition consists of four parts. First is a function keyword with the name of function. Means in a JavaScript, the common way to define a function is by using a function keyword followed by the unique function name, and the name cannot begin with a digit, keyword and a reserve word. Next is a list of parameters enclosed in a parenthesis. Means a list of parameters that may be a empty which is enclosed in a parenthesis. Or next is a code block or a statements. The statement block surrounded by the curly brackets, and the last point is a return keyword which is optional part of a function definition. These main four parts of the function definition, that is name of function with the function keyword, list of parameters, code block or a statements, and the return keyword which is a optional part. Let us see the explanation of each and every part. First is the function name. Function name is any valid identifier, and it is a compulsory, and it indicates the name of function. It is a any valid identifier, and it is a compulsory means required parameter, and it indicates the name of function. Next is a list of parameters enclosed in a parenthesis. Means parenthesis may include the parameters, names and the separated by a commas. Means it includes the parameter names separated by commas. Next is the code block. Code block means what? Or a statement. The statements are a body of the function, and they are executed whenever the function is invoked. Means whenever the function is called, they are executed. And the code to be executed by a function is placed inside the curly brackets. It is placed inside the curly brackets, pair of a curly brackets. Next is a return keyword. Not all the function return a value. For example, suppose a function that display a message on a screen does not need to return a value of the statement that calls the function. Means a return keyword. Not all the functions return a value. Return value are written by the function to the calling function, and return statement can be written only one value at a time. The general form or syntax of the return function is, or return keyword is, return keyword or return expression. Next point is a syntax of defining a function without argument or without parameter. This syntax is a without parameter we can define a function. Syntax is function keyword, function name, and in a parenthesis, no any argument is passes. Without argument we can define a function, and this is the syntax of defining a function without argument. And here is the function body means number of statements or code block. And first of all, open the curly bracket and close the curly bracket. Means in the parenthesis, the code to be executed by the function is placed inside the curly brackets. Next point is the writing a function. We can call a JavaScript function many times to reuse the code. Means the need of a function is it many times to reuse the code. There are two advantages of JavaScript function, that is code reusability. Means what? We can call a function several times so that it saves the coding and it improves the reusability of code. Means same function can be used in any program rather than writing the same code, means the code reusability. And the next, function reduces the size of code, means that or it reduces the duplicate set of statements and replaced by the function call. Means that we do not need to write many lines of code each time to perform a common task. This is the benefits of a function. Or why we use a function? Because reusability is the advantages of a function. Let us see how to write a function in JavaScript. We can write a function with argument and without argument in JavaScript. Here, following is a simple example of a function definition. First, here we take HTML head tag, and here I am closing the head tag. After that, I am writing a script tag. In a script tag, we use a function display, or we define a function display. After that, in that we write document.write hi message. After that, close the script tag, close the HTML tag. You can write the HTML code in a head tag also or in a body tag also. Here in this simple example function definition, here we create one function that is display function, that is function display, and by using write function we display the hi message on a web page. Next point is the adding an argument. When one or more variables that are declared within a parenthesis of a function definition is known as arguments. Means one or more than one variable that declared within parenthesis is called as a argument. These arguments are used to hold the data to perform some task. Syntax with argument or a parameter is function keyword, name of function, and here we pass the parameter list in the parenthesis. Open curly brackets, and here we write the function body, means statements, and close the curly braces. Let us see example of adding an argument. Here function salary, function is the keyword, salary is the function name, and old salary is the parameter list. And in that we write a statement, that is here we create one variable, that is new salary is equal to old salary into 1.25, and close the parenthesis. In this example, old salary is the argument of a salary function, and it display or perform operation, that is new salary is equal to old salary into 1.25. This is a simple example of adding an argument. Next example is you can use as many arguments as necessary. In this example, for the function to carry out its task, and each argument must have a unique name, and each argument within the parenthesis must be separated by the comma. It has a unique name and it is separated by the comma operator. And the two arguments are used in this example is old salary and percent increase, means PR increase. And in that we create one variable, that is new salary is equal to old salary into 1 plus percent salary or percent increase divided by 100. This is a second example of adding multiple arguments in a function. Next point is the example of pass the arguments to user defined function. In this example, here we create HTML tag, head tag, title tag. Here we write a title as a function demo and close the title tag. Here we open a script tag, and after that we create one function, that is display, and here I am passing multiple arguments, that is two arguments in a function, that is name and age. And after that I am writing, or by using write method we display the details, that is name and age, to that on the web page. And here close the script tag, head tag, here close the head tag, open the body tag, close the body tag, and close the HTML tag. This is a simple example to pass argument to the user defined function. Display is the user defined function, and write method is the inbuilt function which is provided by the system. Here head tag is a closed, here head tag is open by mistakenly, so head tag is closed in this example. Next point is the scope of variable and arguments. Question is, explain scope of variables declared in a function with the example. The answer of this question is, there are mainly two types of variables. First is a local variable and a global variable, means a global scope and local scope. Global scope means what? All the variables that you declare is by default as a global scope. And when a variable is declared outside a function with the var keyword, then that variable is a global variable because it is available through all the parts of script. Means it is available throughout the function, so that, or throughout the program, so that it is called as a global scope. Means globally we can use the variable is called as a global variable, and it is declared outside a function with the var keyword. And local variable or local scope means what? All the variables which are declared using var keyword within a function, then those variables are known as a local variables, and they are accessible within a function only. And this concept, you have already learned this concept in a C language. Global and local variables can only be accessible or accessed from within a function. And local variables are recognized inside their function so that variable with the same name can be used in a different functions. And local variables are created when the function starts and deleted when the function is completed. Means its scope is within that function is a scope of a local variable. Next point is write a JavaScript code to demonstrate scope of variable. This is the example of scope of variables. In this example, the function definition is placed within the head tag. The function definition, this is the function definition is placed within a head tag and the function call is placed in a body tag. When the function is called, the browser goes to the function definition. When the function is called, the browser goes to the function definition and executes the statement. It executes the statements in the function definition. Means that it executes this function which is defined in a display function. In this example, the function definition is a display function and in that variable is declared, that is m is a declared variable. Here we declare one variable and initialize the value to m is the thanks. You can insert a JavaScript m in two places. First on the web page within a HTML tag, that is a head tag. In head tag also you can place the definition and in a body tag also you can place a definition. But sometimes a JavaScript developer insert more than one JavaScript into web page. One in the head tag and other in the body tag. The best place to define a function is at the beginning of a JavaScript, that is inserted in the head tag, because then all the subsequent JavaScript on the web page will know the definition of that function. So that the browser always loads everything in the head tag before it starts executing any JavaScript. So that the best place is to define a function is the head tag, in a head tag. So that here in this example, I am taking a function definition at the place of a head tag and function call at the body tag. It displays the global value is equal to welcome and local value is equal to thanks on a web page. First, this is a global variable. Variable g, that is where g is equal to welcome, is a global variable. And here in that function we create one variable, that is where m is equal to thanks. This is a local variable and this global variable is globally accessed throughout the program, so that display function also use this g variable, so that the output of this program is global value is equal to welcome and local value is equal to thanks. This is all about our today's point. Means function definition, writing a function, scope of variable and arguments. Which is already seen or saw this concept or learned this concept in a C languages also. C language also. And in the next lecture, we discuss the next point, that is calling a function. Thank you.